Welcome to the video news of the week. An announcement has come this week from the Trump administration that there will be as much as 20% in new tariffs on lumber imported from Canada. This announcement meant the immediate shutdown of Marcel Lauzon Lumber Mill in East Hereford, Quebec. The mill just across the border from Beecher Falls, Vermont, has stopped taking orders or sending any shipments of lumber purchased from the U.S. loggers and milled at the East Hereford location. Deeming the new tariff awful, a company spokesman told the Chronicle this week that the new provisions could have a devastating effect on the East Hereford firm that relies on business in both raw materials and purchases from the U.S. Lauzon currently anticipates a conference call with the U.S. Commerce Department by the end of the week in hopes of getting an exemption or exclusion from the new tariff. In order for Lauzon Lumber to start shipping again to the States, the company must pay over $400,000 in tariffs immediately to the United States government. This would retroactively cover all of its shipments to the States that had taken place since January 1 through Monday of this week. More information on this developing story can be found in this week's Colebrook Chronicle. An estimated 500 opponents to the proposed Northern Pass Transmission Line project descended on the New Hampshire Statehouse on Sunday afternoon. The gathering was an anti-Northern Pass rally which led to the circling of the Statehouse in a show of unity called Hands Around the Statehouse. Those attending the rally were from all over the state and wore the signature orange color, the opposition's color of choice ever since the project was first announced in the fall of 2010. Participants started gathering at noon and gathered under a large orange balloon that was allowed to be flown at 135 feet from its perch in front of the State House. The balloon's height was a reminder of the height that many of the Northern Pass towers are proposed to be. At about 1 p.m., opponents from a variety of regions around the state spoke to the crowd. Speakers represented Deerfield, Concord, Plymouth, Sugar Hill, and Northern New Hampshire.
Hey, so good afternoon. I'm Brian Tilton, and I am no to Northern Pass. Yeah! Now, what about you? Are you no to Northern Pass?
Yeah!
I want to hear that. I want to hear you say it. I am no to Northern Pass.
Well, we're here to stand united and tell our legislators that it is time to bury this line, either literally or figuratively, because this is the time that our legislators and our decision makers are going to be deciding whether this project has any benefit to New Hampshire. People are realizing that this is coming through their backyard and that actually the biggest visual impacts on this state is in the southern portion of the route. The tallest of the towers will be between Concord and Deerfield, and that's what a lot of people are just starting to wake up to. John Harrigan came up with the idea of having a rally just like this, and as a whole bunch of people started to get together, it just grew organically, and a whole bunch of people started communicating. Thank you, social media. Thank you to digital technology of email and the like, and it just grew from there. And it has turned into what you see here today.
This project is going to start in Pittsburgh and going to end in Deerfield. 11 of those towns are in my district. And I'm not here speaking for me, myself, today. I'm speaking and representing the 11 towns in my district and the people that are there and that are opposed to this project. And when it first started, we said we want to see it buried. I do not want to see it buried. I do not want to see this project in this state at all.
Following the speeches, people surrounded the State House in a statement of solidarity against the controversial Northern Pass project. On Saturday, April 22nd, Earth Day was celebrated in Lancaster with a gathering of talks, music, and displays. Called Earth Day 2017, Think Globally, Act Locally, the event was originally planned to take place on the town common, but was held indoors at St. Paul's Hall due to inclement weather.
We have a great lineup of speakers, of music, lots of kids' activities which are going on in the kitchen and right in front of the kitchen, science activities, art activities. As you all know, we celebrate our Earth, but our Earth is still very much at risk, our air, our water, our land, our climate. And so we hope you all be inspired somehow by visiting our environmental groups that are here today to find some way that you can take action.
I have a state proclamation. It's in celebration of Earth Day and the volunteers that have worked tirelessly to bring about it. It creates the awareness of the importance of protecting our environment.
On Tuesday evening, a recognition ceremony and dinner was held at the Colebrook Country Club for volunteers at the Upper Connecticut Valley Hospital in Colebrook. 18 volunteers were recognized with a total of 2,815 hours of service between them. Also that night, Jerry Owen was awarded for 5 years of volunteer service at the hospital.
For those of you who don't know, which there may be few, Jerry's actually my uncle. So I have literally known Jerry my entire life. Jerry actually worked at the Balsams for 43 years before starting his volunteer service at the hospital. What I've learned from people talking, and then I did ask for some input for tonight just to see what people had to say, is that Jerry has really won the hearts of many staff. So Jerry, we're very glad that you're on our team, and congratulations on your 5 years. And I think I have something here for you.
Monday night, internationally acclaimed five-piece vocal group Home Free performed at Centennial Theater on the Bishop's University campus. The a cappella ensemble were brought to the area by Firehouse Productions, with funds raised from the show to benefit the local Alexander Galt Regional High School sports teams. Colebrook Chronicle Video News of the Week is sponsored by LaPerle's IGA of Colebrook. Great deals and instant coupons can be found on their website at laperlesiga.com. Murphy's Steakhouse at Bear Tree in Pittsburgh. Enjoy casual fine dining, a cozy atmosphere, and wonderful food. Try the chef's table on Sunday evenings. And by Woodsville Guaranty Savings Bank. Friendly local people, friendly local bank. And open 7 days a week inside Lancaster Shaw's. Friday's weather brings rain with a high of 68 degrees. Saturday temps reach a high of 71, and Sunday drops back down to a high of 62 and a low of 44. Thank you for watching the Video News of the Week.